other than the daughter's clothes, right. did you give any of the property?
No, ma'am.
To your son?
No.
No. Other than the daughter's clothes that you think you gave away to Goodwill?
Yes, ma'am.
The boys' things are in there?
Yes, ma'am.
Because they were in a different part of the house. I want to see only your daughter's clothes. With two pairs of jeans, a pair of sneakers, a pair of shoes. Tell me what they were. I will fix
she
it.
Had a backpack, as you can see in these pictures.
Just your daughter. Just
your daughter. She's with her brother, so it's,
it
can't be included. It can't be discluded. But she dropped off with a backpack. She had a purse. She had a Disney dress that was burgundy.
Okay, $200.
She had three pairs of shoes.
Great. Okay, $200. Now,
can I look through it?
No.
Okay.
That's all she says she has.
Yes, but I have proof that they had a backpack when they went there.
How much money did you leave her to take care of your children?
I always leave money and I stopped.
How much money did you leave her to take care of your children for the week?
None for the grandmother. I shouldn't have to leave money, ma'am.
Just a second.
I used to, and then my therapist told me that was a very unhealthy relationship because I shouldn't have to pay.
I'm just asking you how much money you left her to take care of your children for a week.
For
and
this
the answer
trip.
Is nothing.
Mm-mm.
So I'm not interested in you looking in that bag.
Okay.
Now, she has a counterclaim. And her counterclaim is that when you came to the house, she did not turn the children over to you, and you broke down her door. That's her counterclaim.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Did you break down her door?
Yes, she told me that my kids weren't there.
Just a second.
And they weren't.
The answer is you broke down her door.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Can I see the estimate to fix the door?
Yes, ma'am. And these are the pictures of the door, too.
Okay, so I'm going to suggest this to you. It looks like a very good thing if you have an advocate and a therapist. Your advocate and your therapist are going to tell you, if they're smart, that it's a very good thing to keep grandparents the widest possible circle of love around your children.
100%.
So I'm going to keep this very, very simple. She owes you $200 for your daughter's clothes. I assume that your daughter... Put your hand down. I assume that your daughter is a growing person and the things that fit her 8 months ago probably don't. So go out and buy her a couple of new things for $200 if you had it. However, to fix the door that you broke down...
It was more than $200 worth of
clothes. To fix the door that you broke down cost $625.
Yes, ma'am.
So you owe her $425 on her counterclaim.
The door would not have been broken down had she sent them out.
That's what the police are for.
No, I called the police and when the police came, she said that my kids weren't there. We waited 3 hours and they escorted my children out the house.
Just a second. We're here in a civil case. That's what I'm telling you.
They told me if my kids were not in the house that I would be held liable for it.
Ms. Pratt, that's what I'm telling you. You call the police and you wait for them.
I couldn't wait. My children were being dragged upstairs, miss, and I have a video
of that. Judgment on the counterclaim for $425. You left your children there with her for 1 week.
Ma'am,
you
if you read the text message, she asked for them for a couple of days. Bye.
Excuse me, step up.
It was good. You know, because all I wanted to do was see my grandkids.
If you love your grandkids at all, it doesn't matter what's going on between me or you.
I decided I'm just not going to deal with her anymore.
They are in good hands. We have a restraining order that's already been granted.
And that means that I won't be able to see my grandkids.
I've had custody since they were little.
It's very difficult because I love them.